three, and then I will get back to you. So let's
Okay.
start with today's session. So today we'll be
Fine.
doing, today we'll be doing strings, as I said, tuple, set, and dictionary. Okay, so can anyone answer me? You have to answer in the microphone, other than Sushmita and other people. Can anyone answer me what is a tuple? What is the difference between set, list and tuple? Can anyone answer from the other people?
Tuple contains two elements.
Okay, and what does string contain?
Points in a plane.
Okay, and what is the difference with list then?
List contains only one point.
What do you mean by one point?
One element that is like the set of real numbers. So distinct points or same points maybe.
Then what is set?
One at for set we should have distinct points. But
set is
tuple.
Okay, let me make you clear. Set means unique values. Okay, so that is clear to me from what you said. What is tuple then?
In a tuple, two points considered in a single first bracket. Then we should consider the two points together as a tuple.
Okay, and list. Okay, anyways, so I'll give the. So anyone else wants to try? Just.
If I remember correctly, you clearly explained the difference between list and set in the last class, but I don't think we went into the discussion of the distinction between a list and tuple. That's why I think we don't have the answer very well.
Okay, anyone else wants to try? Something which,
the difference between list and set is that the set would be a constant thing. We cannot change anything in it once it is defined.
Okay.
Whereas list can be operated on in various ways. This is what I remember from last class.
And what was the other difference?
Between set and list?
Yes. No, bracket is fine. Third bracket, second bracket is fine. My question is that there are, look, I just hinted what is the difference between list and other type of data that I remember I just hinted, maybe like some people have missed out. But now my question is that I explained set last class and I explained what is a list in the last class, if I remember. My question is that one difference, Sushmita told very clearly, that one is mutable and one is immutable. So you can change in a list anytime, but for set you cannot change. What was the other difference, if you all remember? In the last class, I showed a problem also in the last class to explain why set and list are actually different. Bracket is fine. So one bracket is some curly braces, the other is some other bracket. That is fine. What was the other difference? Basic major difference between set and list, the other difference. Can anyone guess or remember or at least make a wild guess? Okay, I will give the answer. For list, you can have a number twice. So let's say number two can occur two or three or four or five times for a particular list. So let's say you can have a list. If you remember the previous class, okay, I will show you in the previous class. Otherwise, what happened? See, in the previous class, we have discussed very clearly that for a given list you can have the numbers repetitive, so one can be there for once or twice or n number of times, doesn't matter. But for a set, the number should not repeat, it should be unique and should occur only once. That was one difference. The other difference was that in set you can do any kind of operation, you can divide it, cut it or anything, whereas for list you can perform any kind of operation, it's mutable. Whereas for a set, it's immutable. You cannot break it or whatever, you cannot do anything with the set. So that was the one difference. Now, in between a list and a set lies a tuple. So you people might have guessed what is a tuple from this now, as of now. Any guess what should be the tuple? The hint is it lies between list and it lies between a set. So any guess what could be a tuple? So you have two extreme ends. One, you can do anything and it can occur n number of times. The other is it's just unique and you cannot do anything. Yeah. Any try? Anyone? Okay. Tuple is, okay, immutable. Okay. So in tuple, you cannot change the value. That is correct. Let me go back to today's class then. So, yeah. So tuple, T-U-P-L-E, is non-changeable. You cannot change in tuple, but numbers can repeat. So this is the difference between set. This is the difference between tuple, set, and list. You must remember this difference whichever is required for the purpose. You should be using it. See, I'm going little slow so that everyone understands who all are attending the classes. I don't want to make it a rush and then people just consume the thing and forget everything. So I'm going a little bit slow here, but remember this thing is very important to understand. So let's say, tuple is that only, and most of the operations that you can do in tuple are almost similar to what you did in list. So there are not many new differences. In case of tuple, you can find out length of a tuple or whatever we did. Let's define a tuple. So how do you define a tuple? Anyone can answer? Which bracket is used to define a tuple? All right, I got some answers in the chat. Okay, so let's define here. A is equals to 5, 6, 8. Okay, so if I find the len of A, this is 3. So this is how a tuple is defined. And you can perform almost the same operations that you have performed in a list. Other than that, you cannot break it or split it, or the operations that we did in the previous classes for the list, those operations we cannot do it. It's like a fixed value. So let's say I can have a tuple of constants. Right, so you can have a constant, let's say pi is 3.14, exponential is e, what was the value, 2.71, maybe I'm wrong, or so. Okay, this is not a tuple, this is a set, and other constants maybe log, maybe g, then whatever, radius of distance from the sun to the earth, whatever. So these are all constants. So you do not need to change the constants in a particular problem. It need not be you are a physicist, or it need not be your somebody from physics background. You, even if you are from economics or business background, there are always certain constants in your problem. So those constants should not change when your problem is being evaluated. So in those cases, we want to fix those numbers. If somebody has used, I don't know if it is there in C or not, but in Java, I remember there's something called final float. So if you write final float, the number will not change. As far as I remember, I don't know if that same feature is there for C or not. Maybe you can check out. So constant is something, so tuple is something that you will not be able to change at any point of your work. So remember, this is what a tuple is. Now your assignment will be, take any list and then convert it into a set and a tuple and perform the operations that I have shown in the previous class. Okay, you try performing all the operations that I have shown in the previous class and then tell me what all did you get, like which all operations are possible and which all operations are not possible. You have to tell me that is your task for the next session. Conversions are quite similar. Conversions, I'll show you one. So let's say if I want to convert it into a list, then you can just convert it into a list, or you want to convert it into, let's say, a set, then you can convert it into a set. These all operations are more or less similar. You have to tell me which operation is not similar. That's important for this. So this is what, I don't want to spend more time on tuple, because if I do all the problems, you will just be looking into it and might not be practicing. So this is the, these are the two problems which I wanted to show you, and you keep trying on yourself. That will be the best thing. Now let's look into set, little bit of set operations. So set is also similar to what I have taught before, how you do in set. And so let's say, before going to set, we'll be doing strings. Then it will be easier for. So if you remember string, we did in quite detailed, not very detailed, but still we did a quite detailed. So string starts from 0 and to len minus 1, whatever is the len subtracted by 1. So the string, the index of the string starts from 0 and len is minus 1. And if you go into the reverse direction, then it starts from minus 1. So the last element, I'll just show an example in case you people have forgotten. So A of 0 is the first element and A of minus 1 is the last element. That's what it is. And if I want to split a string or something like that, then I can do it in this way. So let's say I want to split it till the second last element. These things I did in my previous classes, just giving you repeating it a little bit. So now let's say I want to convert this string A into a list. So what I'll do, I'll just simply type list and then I'll write A and then I can convert it. So it will convert individual strings into my list. Similarly, if I want to do it in set, then it should do it. So you can see that S is gone, because S is repeating twice, so number is less. And then you want to do it for tuple, and then write down A, and then you should get a tuple. Yeah, so this is how it works. So you can convert from one data type to another data type. This is how the things work. And mostly, these are the basic structures for a string. I'm not going into very details of the string and other stuff which you can perform or look for yourself. For example, I will show two more examples. So one is that, so if in the first class only I have shown what happens with a dot upper should give you the upper. It's already in uppercase, so it's not required. A dot lower should give you this, and s dot title should give you this. It will just capitalize the first word. Remember, let's say I will show a better example. The quick brown my another non-Python question to you all. This sentence is very famous. Does anyone know why this sentence is famous? If you don't know, just check it out, think about it, and tell me why this sentence is very famous. Okay, see, B is this. So let's say B dot title. So you can see the first word of this after the space becomes capitalized if you use B dot title. Okay, so this is the this is what usually the functions do. There are many functions. Like, I cannot teach all the functions in details. I will this. So the one more I will show you. Okay, this replace. I will send you the functions if anyone is interested. I'll send you the functions what all are there. So let's say I want to replace fox with fox. I want to replace fox with cat. Okay. So you can see that it will replace the particular word with the other word. So the quick brown cat jumps over the lazy dog. So this is how it works. Okay, that's correct. Now let's look into the some other problems. So this is, we are done with this list, say list string tuple set. Let's go to dictionary. So what do we mean by dictionary?
Yeah. Sorry, just one question here, that when you made a set out of a string of your name particularly, it replaced, it deleted the first S. Why? First of all, okay, that must be the default, that it would delete the first one. But is it possible that I delete the next S and keep the first one?
But why is that needed in, like, in mathematical, let's imagine a mathematical scenario, okay, where you have a set of apples, orange, banana and all. So why is the ordering required for strings? Can you just why do you think the ordering is needed? It did not delete the first one. It arranged in alphabetical order.
So in case of set, is that also because it does not repeat, so it will always go in the hierarchy of alphabetical order and
you can put it in try it out. You can put this in reverse order also. So
okay.
I will give you a hint here. Yeah. So I'll give you a hint here. Here you have to write something and then it will give you in descending order.
Yes, A dot reverse. Yes.
Something, yeah. You just try it out. You will get it.
Fine.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. So that's good. But I expected one more question, but nobody asked. That's great. My question is that there is, I will not answer it because nobody asked it. The B is here. I changed B dot title. So B got changed, but then I again used the same B and then I used B dot replace. But here it did not capitalize. Here it just changed the first sentence. Why is it so? That's the question. If somebody did not get the question, can just drop me. I will tell, like, I will repeat it, but I'll not give the answer. You people think and let me know. Okay, so that's good. Okay, let's look into dictionary. So dictionary is something that you should follow it little bit indeed with little attention. That's, I feel this is little tricky compared to the other data types. So that's what I feel like. So dictionary is mostly maintained by, so you know what dictionary is, right? Dictionary is, by normal sense, dictionary means a collection of words in a certain particular order. So let's say you are buying an English dictionary or something like that. So it starts from A, ABB, something like that. And for a particular value, you have a set of values. For a particular value, you have a set of values, right? So that is how the dictionary we know in our daily life. Well, here also the dictionary is not completely similar to that kind of dictionary. But here what happens is that for each entry or for each header, let's say, okay, I will give you something like that. Let's say, to make you people clear, I have a tuple. Let's say orange, apple, Mango, Honda City, then what else we have? Tata Nano. Okay, so I just have this, let's say. Okay, I have this. But orange is, oh, sorry, I need to put codes here. Now, what is this? Okay, after the meeting ends, join with the same link. Okay, yeah. So, what is this? What is this data type called? Tell. What is this called? This is a set. Okay, so yeah. So this is how a set is defined. You know, but here you can see one problem is coming. I can only define data in a linear direction, right? What do I mean by linear direction means I can just define the points orange, apple, mango, and cars name. But I'm unable to define that these are fruits, whereas these are cars. I do not have any mechanism by which I am able to say that these are separate objects and these are separate objects. I'm not able to do that. So how do I do it basically? So neither list, set, or tuple can give you that flexibility. So there comes another data type, which is known as dictionary. So I will be showing you a simple example of dictionary before moving into complex examples. So dictionary, let's say student and with a colon, let's say student ID, okay, student ID with a colon 34. Then let's say ER. So this is the year of joining, 2017. And let's say grade 7.2. So this is, if I run it, and now if I check the type of this D, this is showing me dict. Dict means dictionary. So what does this mean? I am saving a particular entry of a student in this format. I have a student ID, year, and grade. This is the format of a dictionary where you have a colon in between and then you can enter the data types. Now it's not over yet. Just be patient. We'll deal it slowly by slowly. Now, the things that you can see out here, the first values are known as keys. Okay, so there are, so let's say, so these things are known as key, K-E-Y. So I'll just make sure that you people understand. These values are known as keys. So this is a key, and this is a key, and this is a key. So these are known as key values. And the next thing that is there, these are values, normal values. Values, this is again, these are value. Okay, so don't forget this, V-A-L-U-E, yeah. This is a value, this is a value. Okay, so this is how you define a dictionary. So you have keys and you have values. Okay, now if you, let's say you do not know, somebody gave you a dictionary. So usually in my case, when I can give an example, people who are connected to astrophysics might understand, who do observational astronomy. When we take a data, to know when the data was taken, from which telescope was taken, we have something called header. And that header is usually stored in the form of a keys. So we have a value and we have some information and another information corresponding to that. So earlier generation people used to do it manually, but now people usually can write the complete information, the background information of any image or spectra or anything in keys. So that in our language we known as header. Whereas in other fields also, in medical records and all, people have particular set of keys, and wherever new patient come for admit, they just fill up the old keys. Like they do not need to type the entire data set ever. Like they do not need to write patient ID is this and something like that. They have keys, and with those keys, they will just enter the values. So once you define your keys, it becomes easier for people to work with. It becomes faster as well as easier. You just need to enter the new values. So that's how the keys and other data types work. So yeah, that's what I wanted to say. So I'll show you some features of this keys, which I feel are important. So one of these is that you want to know the particular keys of, let's say, why is it not showing? Yeah. So if you type d.keys, it will show you what are the keys of the particular dictionary. So you can see student ID, year, and grade. Let's say you want to see what are the values. So d.values. Okay. d.values, if you type it, you should get what are the values of the particular, what are the values in a particular dictionary. So let's say you know how the keys are there. Okay, let's say you know how the keys are there. Just typing a particular, by looking at a particular value, you can tell, okay, so this is the roll number, this is the year, and this is the grade. So this way you can define this. I don't know if you people got what I wanted to say, but you have keys and you have values, and it reduces your work effort to enter new data in your system. So that is how this keys work. So now I will show you some more little details of how dictionary works. So first is inserting new element. New elements. So let's say whatever key you have, you are not happy with that and you want to make something extra. Let's say you have already defined student ID, year, and grade in this dictionary, and maybe you want to add some other parameter. Let's say for example, what else you add for student, I don't know, okay, anything. So what you can do is that you do not need to recreate the dictionary. What you do is that D within brackets, and then you define the space and then pass out, let's say, okay, joining. So let that 2017 be the pass out here. So if you write D dot join and then join here or something, whatever you can write, and then you just insert the values. So say, let's say 2001, I know that's too much, 2006, just do it. Now if you see what is D, you can see that join year is 2006 is taken as a new element in this dictionary. So this is how you can add new elements in the dictionary. This is what you can do. You can do it for n number of times if you want. You just check here. Wait. What happened? Join school or something like that. Test, okay, let's do it in 2211, let's say. Okay, and then you again recheck it, what is there, and it will show you this. Okay, so that's what it is. The meeting can end anytime, so just if it ends, just join in with the link. Okay, now I will show you how to find out, yeah, any questions you anyone is having?
Yeah, but we cannot insert new entries in the middle, can we?
No, you cannot do it the way I'm showing you, but no, you cannot do it actually in the middle. It just adds up to the end, but there are other ways which you can do it in the middle. You have to delete some part and then you have to move and then re-add them later. So that way you can do it.
Yeah, that I can imagine. That's okay.
Yeah, you can. You should be able to do that. So yeah, the meeting is going to end, so just join in with the same link after that. Okay, I will, next we'll be doing searching. So how do we search a new element? So you want to search whether a particular key is there or not in the dictionary. So what you do is that it's very simple. You just write grade in D. So true. That means if it is showing true, that means this key is present in the dictionary. Similarly, let's say I want to write something school. Okay. School in D. It is showing me false. So that means this key is not available. So if you want to check whether a particular key is available or not in a dictionary, then you can use this technique or this function to check whether a particular key is available.